Hello, everyone. I'm Carolyn Meyer. Welcome to Tommy Media's The Locker Room. The St. Thomas football team will spend 2 weeks touring Italy and Ireland this summer, ending with a game in Rome against one of Italy's first division professional teams. In preparation for their travels, the Tommies kicked off the 2018 season this month with practices leading up to this weekend's spring game. Today I'm joined by Coach Glenn Caruso, linebacker Adam Brant, and wide receiver Gabe Green. Thanks for joining us
today.
Thanks
for having us.
So, Coach, since the team will be taking a 13-day trip to Italy and Ireland at the end of this month, how does a trip like this help the team?
Well, a lot of ways it helps the team. I think it gives our players and coaches a perspective that you don't often get when you're playing college football. And there's very few teams that actually make the effort to go overseas. And I think being able to see something, especially how our country is perceived by other countries, how other people live, makes us more well-rounded, more tolerant. And from the logistical part of it, it allows us to get more practices in. And we started doing this back in 2009, the second year that we arrived. And I think it was probably one of the single best things that we ever did, is adding a padded spring. And it certainly takes a competitive group of guys and a lot of work to do it, but that's what we built our team around. So it's been amazing so far.
Mm-hmm. And what is it like ending the tour facing a foreign team?
It's fun. I mean, football over there, it's different than it is over here. It's not, soccer is the big sport over there, you know, and then after that, it's probably basketball and then rugby and football in that order. So it gives us a chance to almost be ambassadors of a sort, and we'll go over there, we'll do youth camps, we'll do clinics. We've had some unbelievable relationships grown from people that were over there 3 years ago, and some of the players that were on the last one are going to be coming over and spending some time with us, and some of our seniors that'll be graduating are going to fly over and meet us in Dublin. And so it's neat to see everybody sort of come together, whether it's in Dublin or Rome, and be around everybody. It's awesome.
Absolutely. And Adam, as Coach alluded to before, since the team is traveling abroad, the program has allowed more spring practices than normal. Looking forward, how do these practices and this Saturday's game help prepare the squad for the fall?
It helps us tremendously. I mean, not a lot of teams get the opportunity to have these extra practices and just kind of mesh with a new group of guys. It's kind of different. Without having to do that in the fall, doing it right now in the spring, it's really going to help us tremendously in the long run. It's a great opportunity that we had.
Mm-hmm. And Gabe, this is your second season as wide receiver after coming to St. Thomas as the quarterback. How will that prior experience help you going into this year?
I just think gaining more experience. These practices have really helped me and our whole offense, because going against, you know, our defense, which is very talented, especially with pads on this spring, we get to, you know, build more communication and relationships through that.
Absolutely. And lastly, Coach, you're going into your 11th season.
Yeah, wow.
And you have made 7 NCAA appearances, 2 of which ending in the Stag Bowl. How has your coaching evolved to help the team win a national championship?
There's so many different ways it's evolved, and actually I think it might be 8 appearances.
But, 8 appearances?
I'm pretty sure. But I just think the way that our team builds upon its culture year after year, kind of like Gabe was alluding to, when you have an opportunity to be in new roles, and you know, look, we graduated 30 unbelievable guys. It's been an amazing spring. We set a national record for fundraising with St. Jude. We set a national record with the Hampshire Award winners in 19. We have 51 guys that are on the Dean's list. That's a great spring. But 30 of those leaders graduated. That's kind of our job as football coaches, to help guys graduate and get out of here, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now this leadership is to be taken up by other people. That's culture, when you can build upon it.
Mm-hmm.
And right after the spring game, we'll have a decade-long celebration where we're going to invite back. We have over 200 people coming back from not just the last 10 years, but even years before that. And just to see the pride and the passion that they have in what these guys are now doing shows us that it's heading in a pretty good direction, and just real, real happy to be able to wave the flag for St. Thomas.
Absolutely, and we are looking forward to this Saturday's game.
It'll be fun.
Thanks for coming in.
Yeah.
The Tommies will hold their spring football game at O'Shaughnessy Stadium this Saturday with a 2 p.m. kickoff. Thanks for joining us. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more Tommie Media content. With Coach Caruso, Adam Brant, and Gabe Green, I'm Carolyn Meyer. For all the latest on St. Thomas sports, be sure to check Tommie Media next semester in The Locker Room.